Hey, Coach Rachit here. Oftentimes, we see people dedicating a season or a specific period for their bulking and cutting phases. Winters are for bulking, and just because you want to see your biceps in your t-shirts, summers are often dedicated for cutting and shredded season.
Bro, sardi aa gayi hai. Pata kya karna hai ab? बल्क शल्क करते हैं, गाजर का हलवा खाएंगे, पिनिया खाएंगे। वैसे भी इसमें किसी को कुछ दिखना नहीं है, मेरी बात मान। गर्मियां आ गई हैं, कट शर्ट करते हैं, गोवा भी तो जाना है, फिर शर्ट नहीं खोलेगा बीच पे।
That's where we are fed and programmed in a way that we automatically think that muscle gains equals to caloric surplus and fat loss equals to caloric deficit. Well, this is mostly true for fat loss, but when it comes to muscle gain, it is not an on and off switch. This is called black and white thinking, and this is not the right way to think. And it's been rightly said that the way you think is more important than what you think. You must be in a caloric deficit to lose fat, which is almost true. But you must be in a caloric surplus to gain muscle, which is not at all true. So for muscle gain, I would just like to highlight that the solution is not black and white. However, the solution lies on a spectrum. The solution lies on a continuum. Now let's redefine on how fat loss and muscle gain occurs. Fat loss is more of an energy dependent process. However, muscle gain is more of a signaling process. Now let's discuss on what goes behind the muscle gaining process. The primary stimulus for muscle growth is progressive resistance training, which is known as progressive overload. So as we all know that muscles are a luxury to our body, and maintaining and building muscles is actually an energy and nutrition costly process. So it's an expensive process to hold and grow muscle, and that's why we need an external stimulus or a reason for our muscles to stay on our body. And that reason or the stimulus comes from progressive resistance training, which is often known as progressive overload. The second factor which is important for muscle growth is the environment for muscle growth. And these things facilitate the growth of muscle. First is protein, second is energy, third is water, and fourth is recovery. All of these things provide a great environment and facilitate the muscle growth. So apart from protein, our body requires some kind of energy for muscle protein synthesis, or in simple terms, the muscle building process. Now, when you are in a caloric deficit, that means lesser external energy is coming into your body. That means lesser food is taken inside the body. Interestingly, in this case, your body can fetch energy from the internal energy resources or reserves like protein, glycogen, and fat. And this can facilitate muscle building process. And guess what? The bros were actually not completely wrong when they say that they can convert fat into muscles. You can definitely take energy from fat and then use it for muscle building process. However, I'm pretty sure that they did not mean it that way. They actually meant that you could directly convert fat into muscles, which is not possible. An important point to note over here is the larger the energy deficit, the lesser will be the muscle building capabilities. The more fat a person carries, the more will be the muscle building capabilities. Comes when people think that they have a specific and a limited time to build muscle, and they go all hard on the surplus, they go earn a very big surplus, and that's where they accumulate a lot of fat. And now they have to spend extra time in a deficit to cut off that fat, and that time could actually be used in a small caloric surplus to continue building muscle. Does that mean that you have to be in a caloric deficit, or I am promoting caloric deficit for muscle gain? No, not at all. The muscle building capabilities are actually enhanced in caloric surplus. The first reason is the muscle protein synthesis actually increases by 30%. The second reason is your performance in the gym increases, and that's where you can do more of the work in the gym. Now, if you are on a deficit and you are still trying to build muscle, these are some strategies which you can intelligently apply in your routine. First, the energy deficit should be smaller just because it has to facilitate the gym performance. Second, improving your peri-workout nutrition. This is where the nutrition around the workouts becomes of utmost importance. You can have more energy around the workout to facilitate the gym performance. Third is slightly more protein overall throughout the day, and spacing that protein in 4 to 5 meals. Try to have some protein source in each and every meal. Obviously, don't just eat nuts and banana in your breakfast. They would actually give you 3 to 4 grams of protein. and that won't actually help you. Fourth is optimizing recovery by sleep and stress management. And fifth is progressive resistance training, as we talked about it earlier. With this, I wrap up my video of calorie deficit and muscle gain. Let me know if you have any kind of disagreements in comments. I'll be happy to have a healthy discussion with you guys. Till then, Coach Rachit signing off. Bye-bye.